listening to the Quill and Big Zack Show.
Hey, everybody. This is your host, Big Zack Richmond, with my co-host, Quill. How you doing, buddy?
I'm doing good. How about you?
Oh, I'm fantastic. Nice, rainy, snowy day. I can't believe it's snowing yet.
I love snow. Snow's great. It's fun to have when you're not driving in it.
No.
Otherwise, it sucks. Or otherwise, it's great. It sucks to drive in.
Yes, it does. And I dread driving in the snow. It's not that I don't trust myself. It's the other 2% people out there who are doing everything but driving. But anyways, we're going to get onto some content here. We've got video games. We got movies. We got TV shows. Those are the discussions for this evening. And Quill's going to start us off with the video games, man. What you got?
Well, I got real excited today because I just learned that Spyro Remastered's coming out this September.
Spyro, all right.
Spyro was the game I played when I was a kid.
Yeah.
When I was like 8 or 6, anything around there, I was playing Spyro. It was
right.
So much fun.
Why don't you, if the listeners here don't know what Spyro is, why don't you give them just a short, quick rundown on what that
is? Sure, yeah. Spyro is a game where you play as a purple dragon, which purple dragons in the lore are one comes every century. Purple dragons are extremely rare, and so they can learn all the elements of the dragons, ice, fire, and all that good stuff. And so the story is about this purple dragon named Spyro who's going around, and in the first game he's, you know, breaking dragons out of stone prisons that they've been encased in.
Mm-hmm.
He's, you know, finding fairies and freeing the people of all the different lands.
Okay, and what is Spyro's attack? What's his ability? What does he do?
His main ability in the first games, first three, is he just breathes fire. He can also charge and headbutt things, but
okay.
You can find power-ups. They give you ice and fireballs and things like that. In the later games, so that came out for the PS2, he could learn things like lightning breath and ice breath and different types like that.
Okay, so different elemental abilities.
Exactly.
So do you think that this game should have been remastered?
I definitely think this game should have been remastered.
Okay.
It's a great puzzle-solving game. It's a great game. You could just sit down and play for hours and then play again and again and again. This is just a really fun game.
Yeah.
And its graphics do not hold up over the years.
Yep. So what do we got next, Quill? What's the next game?
Next up, coming out later this year in May, sooner than Spyro, is State of Decay 2. I played the first game a lot. It's a zombie survival game. You collect resources. You collect survivors. You build up a base, and you can build gardens and all sorts of things for your base to defend yourself against the zombie hordes.
Nice. I like the fact that you can build your base and protect yourself. It gives you something to like localize. It's not just a run around shooter, you know, where you're just smashing skulls and, you know.
I mean, there's a lot of that in the game as well. But
well,
yes,
yeah.
I agree. There is. It's fun to have the aspect of like it's not all run out and kill. It's, you know, you got to keep people alive. You got to keep people happy. There's a whole moral bar on your HUD when you're in the camp to make sure people stay happy.
Yeah, and I heard that there's a promotion factor in that. So you like build a base. You have people who are working hard. You see that they're working hard, and you promote them up in kind of like a ranking system. In the midst of your little base, which I think is kind of cool.
That is a very cool thing.
Yes.
And so the second one's going to have, for one thing, there were these zombies called juggernauts, which were huge, like just giant guys, were like 4 times the size of a survivor.
Yeah.
And they weren't really too hard to deal with. Their only attack was they would just charge at you and you would just move out of the way.
Mm-hmm.
Now, one thing they could do is just stop a car dead in its tracks.
Yes.
And so in the new one, they've made glats way harder to the point where they can just wipe out your entire team of 4 people easily. So they have become much more dangerous.
I bet that's a tense moment in the game, huh?
Oh, I'm sure. Those are the best moments, though. The best moments when you're just like, time to run, not fight. Those are the best times.
Definitely.
Another one coming out next, pretty soon here, is Spider-Man.
Spider-Man. Hey. I'm a big Spider-Man fan, so I'm kind of excited about it. But I'm a little disappointed that it's only coming out on PlayStation.
I'm disappointed about that, too. But it does make sense, seeing how Sony owns Spider-Man.
Yeah.
And they're a very PlayStation-focused company.
Yes, they are.
So, You know, what's interesting about it is that they're coming out with the fact that they are only going to do, they're taking a whole new, like, aspect on it where they have done, they're doing Peter Parker still, but it's, or at least for some of it, and then they're doing Miles Morales, and that's something that the movies or the comics haven't done yet.
The games haven't come out with
Miles Morales in their games yet.
No, so they had a whole new spin. I did see that they're coming out with this really cool kind of, like, a box set. For the game, and it looks pretty BA, man. I'm excited about that. But I have a hard time dropping over $100 on a game.
I agree.
I'm cheap. I'm sure that kids living at home where you're spending mommy and daddy's money all the time, it probably doesn't matter to them, but when you're on a budget and you're making your own money, $100 plus for a box set of a game, kind of, you know, unless you're a real super-duper hardcore collector of Spider-Man stuff, I couldn't see spending that money on that, but that's just me. What else we got?
Well, next, I think we should talk about a Dark Souls remaster coming out.
Dark Souls. That's
right.
That's a tough game.
That is a very tough game. It's a whole tough set of games. The second one, not as good as the first or third. I liked the third the most, but they're coming out with the remaster for the first one.
Yeah.
And even the just beginning part of that game was immensely brutal to the players. Like, it was just, get out of the prison cell, here's your broken sword, go survive. And it was like, oh, you're going to get shot immediately by snipers down this hallway. And
oh, yeah.
You go past there, it's like, here's a demon, fight that.
Here's a demon and a wooden sword. Good luck.
That's right.
But we're going to go pay some bills, and when we come back, we're going to talk about some movies. Stay tuned, listen in, and we'll be right back after this.
Do you want to get free home internet for life? Well, you can with AT&T's new Unlimited Plus Enhanced Wireless Plan. Switch to the AT&T Unlimited Wireless Plan, and you'll be saving a whole lot of green at less than $48 per line with 4 lines. Still want more? Add lines 5 through 10 for only $30 per month. Call 844-787-6479 to order. That's 844-787-6479 to order your free home internet for life. AT&T, your world. Welcome back, everybody. And I think our next segment is Big Z here has got some movies for us.
Oh, yeah. Okay, so movies. There are some really highly anticipated movies that are coming out. We got Avengers Infinity Wars. I wanted to start right off with that because as a Marvel fan and a movie fan of Iron Man, of Captain America, of Thor,
all the
Spider-Man, I could not be more excited about this. This is a comic book series that I have been longing to see on screen since a little kid.
I'm glad they're doing justice to the comic books.
Oh, yeah. They are doing real good justice to the comic books. And I really like how, through the series of movies, each character has kind of evolved. Iron Man in his multiple different suits that he's had. Thor losing his hammer and gaining this, like, new electrical ability, which is pretty cool.
He has become the God of Thunder.
Yeah, he truly is now kind of morphed into that character. We got Spider-Man, who just recently had another reboot, which, you know, I'm sure everybody's got their opinions on that, but
he
looks pretty awesome, and I'm very happy with the character that the guy who they got to play him.
He plays, he plays the voice of the, Disney Channel, Spider-Man show, like the animated one.
Oh,
he's the actual voice of that kid.
You know, I did not know that. Well, it goes to show you how much Disney I watch. Anyways, I probably could talk a good hour just about that Avengers movie, but I'm going to move on. Our next movie, Black Panther, which is out. Great movie, well-written, filmed very well. I thought it was filmed very well. The only thing that I did not like about this movie were the action scenes with the Black Panther.
Oh?
I know, everybody's like, oh, that's a big gasp. Okay. The scenes are so shaky, you can't actually see the action that's going on in the movie. it happens so fast, and the camera's just like all over the place. Like, and I don't know if that was intentional or, I mean, I'm sure it's intentional. I mean, when they're filming
sure
something like that, they laid that out. But let's, I'm going to reference to Wonder Woman, okay? Wonder Woman, I love that movie. I think that's probably one of the, arguably, one of the best Marvel movies there is.
It is arguably the only good DC movie that ever came out since, you know, like, Man of Steel.
And I know that's a DC movie, but just the way it was shot, where her fight scenes were so fluid and you could see all the action. You could see every hit. You could see the reaction done by the characters that she's hitting and stuff like that. Or let's go to Captain America. The scene where he's running the ship and whooping the crap out of people.
That's a great scene. I mean... He's just like, I'm going to jump out of the plane. You want a parachute? Nah, I'm good.
I think of all the Marvel movies, that's the best opening to any of them.
That is a good opening.
I mean, he just goes through and he just cleans house. But you see all the action. There is no, like, question, well, how did he do that? You know what I mean?
Right.
It was straight up hand-to-hand fighting. And you would think that the Black Panther would be the same way, but it's not. And it kind of bothers me.
Enlighten us. How is it so shaky? See, I haven't seen the movie, as I'm sure some of you haven't.
Okay, so let's just say there's a scene in the movie where they're tracking down this convoy of guys.
Okay.
And they're like gorillas.
Mm-hmm.
And they shut down. He jumps over the cars and he throws this little electrode on the car and it sends like this pulse through the vehicle and it mm-hmm. dies. And then there's the scenes where, I mean, you see them attacking him, but it's so broken up and shaky that you can't see what he's actually doing. You know what I mean?
And they could have been doing it as like, because the Black Panther has always been sort of a stealthy character, where like you see glimpses of him and then like someone just gets pulled off the screen. They might have been going for that effect.
Yeah, yes and no. I mean, but then later on in the movie, there's parts where he's doing these ceremonial battles. I'm trying not to like, if you haven't seen the movie, I'm trying not to give it too much away.
Spoilers.
Spoiler! So, he's being contested for his throne by this other guy. And those scenes are a little better. The camera's not as shaky. And I don't know why they have to overshake the cameras. You have to watch it to see what I'm talking about.
Well, I might just might then.
Oh, yeah. I hope so. But let's move on. I'm sure I could rant about Black Panther all day. Another comic book movie coming out, Deadpool 2.
Oh, I can't wait for this.
I'm pretty stoked. They're not releasing a whole lot about the movie just yet. I mean, there's still some speculation on storyline and that sort of thing. But it looks, I mean, if it's anything like the first one, I'm going to love it.
Oh,
and,
I'm sure.
And I think Ryan Reynolds was made for that part.
Ryan Reynolds plays that character to a T.
Yes, he does. I'll be honest with you, I couldn't see anybody else playing that character.
Or
voice him. For that instance.
He does it so well.
He does do it so well. Then we got a video game that was made into a movie, Rampage, with The Rock. Looks pretty amazing.
Oh, I play that game.
I guess
a lot.
The Rock's a caretaker for this silverback gorilla.
Okay.
And well, I think he's
George.
Like George, yeah. He somehow gets infected with a chemical, and it makes mm-hmm. him grow huge.
Ah.
And he's not the only one. This company that had producing this chemical, I guess, makes a bunch of different other big monsters, you know?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
So,
I remember in the game, the company was putting chemicals in soda, and then they would give
yeah,
these kids
soda.
Pop, and they would drink it, and they would just turn to giant monsters.
Yeah, yeah. The other movie that I want to talk about is Pacific Rim Uprising. This initially was thought to be a prequel, but it's not. It actually takes place years after the first movie.
Interesting.
I watched a pretty long trailer on it.
Okay.
It's being made in 3D at the IMAX.
That's going to be awesome.
Which, when I went to the theater the other day, I was a little torn. Do I go see Black Panther or do I see
Pacific Rim
mm-hmm. in 3D at the IMAX? It was really hard to decide.
Which did you choose?
We saw Black Panther.
Ah, do you regret that decision?
No, I do not, because
okay.
I mean, I really enjoyed it. I'm definitely going to be going back and seeing Pacific Rim because it looks amazing. All in all, it's just a big glorified Godzilla movie. These are just modern Godzilla movies, basically, is what it is.
It really is. It's just like a bunch of Godzillas fighting a bunch of giant robots. It's awesome.
It is awesome.
The first one was a really... I liked the first one. The first Pacific Rim was a well-made movie.
Yeah, that it was. That it was. But let's go ahead and take a break. And when we come back, we are going to talk about a little bit of TV show. So stay tuned.
Guitar Center is home to the world's largest selection of popular guitars, basses, amplifiers, keyboards, workstations, drum percussions, microphones, PA systems, DJ equipment, stage lighting, recording software, studio gear, and more. Backed by over 260 stores across the country, GuitarCenter.com offers the fastest, easiest way to find all the gear you need in one place. And while many popular instruments are available for the same-day pickup at the store near you, we also offer free shipping on thousands of items from the Guitar Center location of your choice. Because of our incredible buying power and strong relationships with all the top musical instrument brands, you are sure to find the best gear at the guaranteed lowest price. From the new Gibson US 2016 updates to the largest collection of Strats, we've got everything a guitarist could ask for, not to mention our vast collection of effects pedals and accessories. Come into our Villa Park location, located at 298 West Roosevelt Road in Villa Park, today.
All right, we're back. Big Z and my man Quill.
What's up?
Hope you enjoyed the music. We are going to talk about some TV shows now at the getting down to the wire here. I want to talk about Ash versus the Evil Dead. I don't know if you've seen the show or not.
I have not.
Are you familiar with the movies?
I am. I have seen a small amount of the first one, haven't seen any of the others. But I understand the premise and how it works and the way the movies go.
Okay.
The plot line.
Well, this is just a continuation of those movies. With a plot twist and new characters. I love it. It's gory. It's funny. It's well written, it's well shot, it's just all around entertaining. If you don't find Bruce Campbell entertaining. We are going to talk about some TV shows now at the getting down to the wire here. I want to talk about Ash versus the Evil Dead. I don't know if you've seen the show or not.
I have not.
Are you familiar with the movies?
I am. I have seen a small amount of the first one, haven't seen any of the others, but I understand the premise and how it works and the way the movies go.
Okay.
The plot line.
Well, this is just a continuation of those movies, with a plot twist and new characters. I love it. It's gory, it's funny, it's well written, it's well shot, it's just all around entertaining. If you don't find Bruce Campbell entertaining, you have problems. I think he's probably arguably one of the best B actors. I don't know if you can consider him a B actor.
Yeah, you probably could, yeah.
I love him. I think it's great. Another show that just came back on the air after years and years and years of being off, Roseanne.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, I can't say enough about that show. I really, really enjoyed the first and actually second episodes. I watched both episodes. They were really, really good. Modern feel to them, modern topics, modern situations, and still the great sarcasm of Roseanne and Dan. They're just amazing. They got all the cast and crew together for it. It's just fantastic. But we're going to sign out for the night. I want to thank my partner, Quill. I'm Big Zack. Thank you for listening. Tune in next time. You guys have a great night. Take a number. I was lightning before the thunder. Thunder, 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 thunder. Feel the thunder. Lightning and the thunder. Thunder, feel the thunder. Lightning and the thunder. Thunder, thunder. Kids were laughing in my classes while I was scheming for the masses. Who do you think you are? Dreaming about being a big star. They say you're basic, they say you're easy. You're always riding in the backseat. Now I'm smiling from the stage while you were clapping in the nosebleeds.